At this very moment, there are thousands of trains connecting different parts of the world. Trains that cross paths, cross mountains, and draw colorful lines in cities. It's an environmentally friendly, flexible, and safe means of transport. As a result, it's experiencing a significant growth in use, especially in Europe. One of the key points for the safety of all these trains is to know their absolute position at all times. Trains are currently able to calculate their speed, read the beacons placed on the tracks, and calculate how far they are from the last beacon read. The onboard unit is responsible for sending all this information to the control points installed on the ground, which, together with the help of additional sensors, make it possible to locate all trains. To obtain accurate information on a train's position with the current system, there must be a beacon installed approximately every 1.5 kilometers. This requires a significant investment in terms of both infrastructure and maintenance. Faced with this situation, at CAF, we are opening a new path towards the future of train localization. We have over 100 years of experience in integrated transport systems. Our projects stand out due to their advanced technology and respect for the environment, which has helped us to position ourselves as leaders in electric mobility. CAF is the driver of this train that is starting to cover its first kilometers. But we are not traveling alone. We have the collaboration of Euskotren and the involvement of European projects funded by Shift to Rail. Together, we want to take you to a place where no train has gone before. Are you coming with us? A new path to the future of train positioning.
IPAR was created to move the knowledge of the train's absolute position to the train depending as little as possible on the track infrastructure. The obvious approach is to make use of the global navigation satellite system as is used in aviation and maritime services. Therefore, research began on the availability of GPS with EGNOS and the new European constellation of satellites, Galileo.
If aviation already has this technology, why not implement it?
The challenge for the rail sector is to introduce the technology without affecting current availability and safety standards. The problem is that the GNSS signal suffers significant distortions due to the train's local surroundings, where there might be many buildings, coverage is lost in the trees, or even high hills near the track. If we add to this that the parallel distance between train tracks are only 4 meters apart, then the problem becomes even more complicated.
IPAR is a viable system that brings us nearer to a future that is very close. At CAF, we have developed a demonstrator in which we have integrated digital inertial sensors, GNSS receivers, and digital map management applications.
CAF's proposal is based on making the most of the information obtained by inertial sensors, which, together with already available speed sensors, pre-processed maps, GNSS receivers, allows us to position the train safely on the track.
The end of this journey is already on the horizon, with very interesting advantages for both the railway sector and for the future of mobility. IPAR contributes to the reduction of onboard hardware, as the odometry system can now provide absolute positioning to other subsystems. IPAR also contributes to the reduction of on-track equipment, mainly in the repositioning beacons installed. IPAR opens up a range of new opportunities to develop onboard applications based on absolute positioning, such as onboard energy management, for more efficient use. IPAR will also contribute to future developments of the autonomous train, where both the train's absolute position and the current direction of movement are key information for train control systems. Want to know what the next station has in store for us? Keep an eye on us.